Welcome to the Iowa DOT's 511 how-to videos. This video will show you how to save a route. This can later be used to view all of the traffic events in a list view along your route, or to get personalized alerts via text or email, or to report winter road conditions. Let's get started. Make sure that you're signed in. In the upper right-hand corner, it should have your first name and say Joe's 511, or your name. Then you can go over here and you can click on Joe's Favorites. This will show you all of the routes or areas that you have saved. Currently, we don't have any. If I want to go back to the home screen, I just click Home, the home icon at the top. At any time, I can click on the magnifying glass icon, and this is where I can start saving my route. I can zoom to a place, and these use all Google Map type locations. So major points of interest, for example, Adventureland amusement park, you can type that in and click search. Or just a city or an address. So that's if you want to zoom to a specific place. So we'll start with Adventureland. And you'll see the options as you start typing. So we'll select that and click search. And it zooms me to the area of Adventureland and shows me the events that are occurring in that area. If I want to go back, I can click on the search button again. Now let's say I want to pick a route and I want to drive from Mason City to Waterloo. I'm planning a trip. So I'm going to start my point A at Mason City. I'm going to end in Waterloo. And then I'm going to click search. And if you've used Google Maps before, you'll notice this is pretty similar to how that works. Now your routes are directional, so it's only going to show you traffic impacts that are happening in the direction of travel from Mason City to Waterloo. So if you wanted to get alerts in both directions, you would need to then do a Waterloo to Mason City, and that would show the other direction. So right now, you'll see if I click or hover over that, it shows highlights the blue circle down closer to Waterloo. If this isn't the exact route that I want to take or that I want to save, I can just highlight over the route and you'll see the white dot appear. It says drag to change route. And I can drag that. Let's say I want to go through New Hampton. And I just drag it out there and it's saved. And I can do that as many times as I'd like along that route. So this is the route that I want to save. And I click on Save this route, and you can rename it or leave it as the default Mason City to Waterloo. I'm just going to leave it. Now, if I click on the yellow star, that will take me to my favorites. These are the saved routes or areas that I have previously saved. So here's the Mason City to Waterloo route, and you'll see it shows a general direction of travel from Mason City to Waterloo. If I click on that, it's going to show me the route that I saved over in the map area. It will also show me all of the events that are currently happening in that area. I can go back to my favorites by clicking on the star. Now, if I click on that and I want to edit the route, I can click on the three horizontal lines and it'll allow me to edit. that route. And click Save. If you want to save an area, click on the Save Another Route or Area. And I can select a predefined area, for example, statewide, if I want to see all of the events in the statewide area, or I can go to these metro areas around the state, or our predefined regions. So let's say I want to save Central Iowa. So I've clicked on Central Iowa, and if you zoom out a little bit, you'll see the area that that includes. It's the non-grayed out area. That will show you all of the events that are happening in Central Iowa right now, or that are going to be happening. These are the future events. So I want to save this area to my favorites, and I will leave it as Central Iowa, and I'm going to click Save. So now you'll see under My Saved Areas, instead of My Saved Trips, it'll show Central Iowa. And I can hover over that, and it shows the area that's included. Thanks for watching this training. You can find more 511 help videos under the help link at the top of 511ia.org.